हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 24/7। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस, इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिक व्हीकल पॉलिसी एंड आल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अंडमान निकोबार एज अ मैरीटाइम एंड स्टार्टअप हब एंड आल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फर्स्ट सिल्क ट्रेनिंग एंड प्रोडक्शन सेंटर दैट इज गोइंग टू बी सेट अप इन अरुणाचल प्रदेश। So do watch the complete session and spread the knowledge. So chaliye start karte hain with question number 1. Identifying a great potential of silk production and other activities of village industries in one of the villages of Arunachal Pradesh, setting up of a training cum production center is sanctioned for the silk which is traditionally worn by the local tribals. So with respect to this center, we have to identify the correct statement. Okay, so let us first discuss about the news. So the news is that there will be first silk training cum production center that is going to be set up in Arunachal Pradesh by Khadi Village and Industries Commission in the tribal village of Chullu in Arunachal Pradesh. Ek village hai jiska naam hai Chullu, Arunachal Pradesh mein, wahan pe Khadi and Village Industries Commission dwara pehla silk training cum production center banaya jayega in Arunachal Pradesh. And guys, Khadi and Village Industries Commission is headquartered in Mumbai and it is headed by Mr. Vinay Kumar Saxena. All right. And this training cum production center will be established to provide training and then employment to the local people of the village through silk production. अब इससे ये होगा जो वहाँ के local tribals हैं उनकी जो employment है उसके chances बढ़ेंगे और generally हमारे देश में जो tribal people हैं उनके employment के लिए बहुत कम चीज़ें की जाती हैं but now this step is a major step in towards providing employment to the tribal people of the village Chullu in Arunachal Pradesh. And guys, if we talk about the significance of this step, that there will be training of artisans supporting the production of airy silk, which is indigenous to the northeastern state. And this will also help in creating local employment and sustainable development in the region. And KVIC also aims to connect this center with the Zero tourist spot. Zero is a tourist spot in the lower Sumasri districts of the Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. And guys, if we talk about this airy silk, so airy जो word है वो आता है word era से, जो कि एक Assamese word है. Okay, it is derived from the word era, which is an Assamese word, and era means castor. Okay, era means castor, and castor word इसलिए इस्तेमाल किया गया है इसके लिए because the silkworm producing this airy silk feeds on the castor plant. Okay, जो silkworm एरी सिल्क प्रोड्यूस करता है वो कैस्टर प्लांट के ऊपर फीड करता है, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नेम्ड एज एरी, व्हिच इज डिराइव फ्रॉम द वर्ड एरा इन द फ्रॉम द एसएमईज व्हिच मींस कैस्टर. ऑलराइट, सो देयरफॉर गाइस नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. सो विलेज ऑफ चांगलांग अरुणाचल प्रदेश इज सिलेक्टेड फॉर द सेंटर. नो, विलेज नेम इज नॉट चांगलांग. ट्रेनिंग कम प्रोडक्शन सेंटर इज सैंक्शन फॉर ऑल टाइप ऑफ स्किल. नो, इट इज जस्ट फॉर एरी सिल्क व्हिच इज इंडिजीनियस फॉर द एरी सिल्क. And for airy silk, remember one more thing, that northeast India में पाया जाता है and some parts of China and Japan it is also found, and in some parts of India it is also known as ND. It is also known as ND or Randy. Okay, so now this statement is also incorrect, and the third statement is KVIC also aims to connect this center with the tourist visiting Sela Pass tourist spot. No, not with Sela Pass, with Zero tourist spot. KVIC aims to connect this center. So all the statements are guys incorrect. So therefore the correct answer will be what? Option E. All are incorrect. And now let's move on to question number 2. So guys, question number 2 and 3 is all about the development of Andaman and Nicobar Islands as a maritime and startup hub. So now let us first discuss about the news. So recently the Prime Minister of India has declared that the Andaman and Nicobar Islands will be developed as a maritime and startup hub. And these are some important points that you have to note about this news. So first of all, a transshipment hub has been proposed in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and I hope aapko transshipment hub ke bare mein pata hai. Transshipment concept ye hota hai, basically ye ek factory hai, yahan se kisi goods ki shipment hui to a port or some you can say intermediate destination, and then is intermediate destination se jo vehicle tha wo change hua from ship to a truck, and then it is delivered to the retail shop owners या फिर wholesale shop owners. Okay, so this is known as transshipment concept. Basically, transshipment concept का मतलब होता है कि जो जहाँ पे intermediate destination included होता है. Okay, यानी कि एक major destination जो कि between two destination, जब एक intermediate destination आता है तो इसको हम बोलते हैं transshipment concept. Okay, and 12 islands of this archipelago have been selected for high impact projects with an emphasis on boosting trade of sea based organic and coconut based productions of the region. एक सबमरीन केबल प्रोजेक्ट है दैट हैज बीन लॉन्च इन द आइलैंड्स टू मेक इट डिजिटली इंडिपेंडेंट एंड पोर्ट ब्लेयर एयरपोर्ट को एक्सटेंड किया जाएगा एंड उसको बहुत सारे आइलैंड्स के साथ जोड़ा जाएगा एंड सम ऑफ द आइलैंड्स विल आल्सो बी कनेक्टेड विद द सी प्लेन्स ओके एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट गाइस बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट सो इन 2015 द गवर्नमेंट हैज अनाउंस्ड रुपीज 10,000 करोड़ इकोनॉमिक प्लान टू ट्रांसफॉर्म द अंडमान एंड निकोबार आइलैंड्स इनटू द कंट्रीज मैरिटाइम हब 2015 में ही इसको अनाउंस कर दिया गया था गवर्नमेंट द्वारा और 10,000 करोड़ रुपए भी अनाउंस कर दिए गए थे ताकि हम अंडमान निकोबार को एक इंडिया का पहला मैरीटाइम हब कन्वर्ट कर सके दिस इंक्लूडेड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ ओरिजिनल जरावा इनहैबिटेंट्स एंड बूस्टिंग द टूरिज्म पोटेंशियल इन द अंडमान एंड निकोबार एंड गाइज वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट इज टू बी नोटेड हेयर इज दैट ऑन 1 June 2017 गवर्नमेंट हैड कंस्टिट्यूटेड Island Development Agency and the meetings of Island Development Agency is headed by the Union Home Minister. Alright, this is very important. अगर ये कभी भी एग्जाम में पूछा गया तो कभी भी आपका दिमाग Home Minister की तरफ नहीं जाएगा. So remember this thing that the meetings of Island Development Agency is headed by the Union Home Minister, which is currently Mr. Amit Shah. Okay, so this was about the news. Now let's move on to question number 2 and 3. So recently, Prime Minister has declared that the Andaman and Nicobar Islands will be developed as a maritime and startup hub. Which is are the reasons among the following for selecting this island to be developed as a maritime and startup hub? इनमें से क्या reasons हैं क्योंकि ताकि हम इसको maritime and startup hub में convert कर रहे हैं? So statement 1 is the islands are critical for India's security because of their strategic location in the Indian Ocean region. Yes, this is very important point about the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. These are very important as if you talk about the India's security. And statement number 2 is the islands are home to India's only Tri-Services Command, Andaman and Nicobar Island Command. Yes, केवल इकलौती Tri-Services Command Andaman and Nicobar Command है. So this is also the reason. So therefore the correct answer will be what? Option C. Both are correct. And now question number 3. Which is not one of the proposals for developing Andaman and Nicobar Islands as a maritime and startup hub. इनमें से क्या एक proposal में नहीं है? A transshipment hub has been proposed in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Yes. 12 islands of the archipelago have been selected for high impact project. Yes. This is absolutely correct. A submarine cable project has been launched in the islands to make it digitally independent. Yes. This is also correct. And Port Blair Airport is to be expanded. Yes. This is also correct. So therefore, the correct answer will be guys what? Option E. All of the above are correct. And now let's move on to the next news, which is about the negative list of 101 defense items. So aap sabne suna hoga ki defense ministry ne ek 101 items ki list nikali hai jinki import jo hai ministry defense band kar dega un sabhi items ko india mein manufacture kiya jayega. Okay, so ministry of defense has announced a negative list of 101 defense items that the MOD will stop importing. This list is included which type of the defense items? इनमें से किस तरीके के defense items इस list में included हैं? So recently Ministry of Defense which is headed by Mr. Rajnath Singh Lok Sabha constituency is Lucknow. Lucknow is the capital of Uttar Pradesh. So Ministry of Defense has announced a negative list of 101 defense items that the MOD will start importing and these items will be manufactured in the country and it will provide a boost to vocal for local that was announced by Prime Minister under the Atmanirbhar package and these are some benefits. So it will boost Indian defense industry and the Atmanirbhar jo mission hai hamara ye usko bahut acche tarike se boost provide karega and also jo hamare domestic manufacturers hain unki income ko bhi ye support karega and jo turnover target hai of the Ministry of Defense to reach a turnover of $25 billion by 2025. This step will also help in achieving this target by production of items domestically. Okay, and the export opportunities will also be enhanced after this decision because of course जब हमारे खुद की production बढ़ने लगेगी और जो हमारा खुद का domestic manufacturing बढ़ने लगेगा तो obviously जो भी हमारा surplus item होगा that we will export to other countries and government also sets a target to export these indigenously manufactured defence products worth $5 billion by the year 2025. It will also reduce the import bill and also guys employment generation bhi hoga because obviously agar hamare desh mein manufacturing badhegi to it will create jobs for our citizens. Okay, so now let's move on to the question. Question is, this list is included which type of the defense items. And let me tell you one thing, that within the Ministry of Defense, the highest decision making body is Defense Acquisition Council. Okay, Defense Acquisition Council is the highest decision making body within the Ministry of Defense, and it is chaired by the Union Minister of Defense, and it was established in the year 2001. Okay, so now, defense items which are very expensive, no. Defense items which are not useful now, no. Defense items imported from China, no. Defense items which could be manufactured in India, ye hamara sahi jawab ho sakta hai. So therefore the correct answer will be what? Option D. And now let's move on to question number 5, which is the last question for today. The Delhi government's new electric vehicle policy aims at boosting the economy, reducing pollution and encourages usage of e-vehicles. Following are the benefits given under this policy except. Iske alawa guys, FAME India scheme bhi hamare desh mein chal rahi hai by the Union government. जिसके तहत काफी सारी सब्सिडीज प्रोवाइड कराई जाती हैं ऑन द परचेजिंग ऑफ ई व्हीकल्स. ओके, एंड नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स पॉलिसी ऑफ दिल्ली. सो दीज आर सम फीचर्स. सो देयर विल बी एन इंसेंटिव ऑफ ₹30,000 ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक टू व्हीलर्स, ऑटोज एंड ई रिक्शास, एंड अप टू ₹1.5 lakh ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक कार्स. सो दिस इज अ ह्यूज इंसेंटिव दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज गिविंग, 30,000 ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक टू व्हीलर्स, ऑटोज एंड रिक्शास, एंड 1.5 लाख ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक कार्स. एंड इन द लग्जरी सेगमेंट एंड जो सर्टेन पार्ट्स ऑफ सिटी है उसमें कंजेशन फी लगाया जाता है, इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स को उनसे एग्जेम्प्ट रखा जाएगा. इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल्स विल बी एग्जेम्प्टेड फ्रॉम द कंजेशन फी एंड द लग्जरी फी, और उनके ऊपर जो रोड टैक्स है गाइस वो भी कम कर दिया जाएगा बाय द दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट. एंड देयर विल ऑल्सो बी सम स्क्रैपिंग इंसेंटिव. और ये स्क्रैपिंग इंसेंटिव क्या होता है? सो व्हेनेवर वी एक्सचेंज एन ओल्ड फ्यूल बेस्ड व्हीकल with a new electronic vehicle, then also the cost of electric vehicle will be reduced. Okay, जब भी हम अगर हम कोई नया electric vehicle खरीदने जा रहे हैं, in the exchange of an old fuel based vehicle, then the cost will be reduced of the new electric vehicle. Okay, and interest rate loans will be provided at a lower rate on buying commercial electric vehicles, and also कुछ subsidies, road subsidies दी जाएंगी, and also the road tax और जो registration fee है उनको भी waive off कर दिया जाएगा by the Delhi government on purchasing of the electric vehicles. At present, road tax ranges from 4% to 10% of the cost of the vehicle, while the registration fee could be up to ₹30,000. ये सब कुछ waive off कर दिया जाएगा by the Delhi government according to the new electric vehicle policy. And remember one very important thing is that these grants will be in addition to the subsidies offered by Union government under the FAME India Phase 2 scheme. ऐसा नहीं है कि अगर कोई FAME India Phase 2 के अंदर subsidies ले रहा है तो उसको ये subsidies नहीं दी जाएंगी. These subsidies will be given in addition that is offered by the Union government under its FAME India Phase 2 scheme. Okay, and if you talk about the there will be state electric vehicle board, state electric vehicle fund, an electric vehicle cell, and also 100 electric vehicle charging station will be set up in the next one year. अगले एक साल में 100 electric vehicle charging station setup कर दिए जाएंगे दिल्ली में. Okay, so guys, this was all about the electric vehicles policy, and now let's move on to the question. So following are the benefits except incentive of ₹30,000 on electric two wheelers, rickshaws and e-rickshaws. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Incentive of up to ₹1.5 lakh on electric cars. This is also correct. Low interest rate loans on buying commercial electric vehicles. Yes. Road tax and registration fee waivers for EVs bought in the capital. Yes, this is also correct. Beneficiaries of FAME India Phase 2 scheme are not eligible to avail the benefits. No, they are also eligible to avail the benefits of this policy. So therefore, the correct answer will be what, guys? Option E. Beneficiaries of FAME India Phase 2 schemes are also eligible to avail the benefits of the above policy. Okay, guys. So that's it for the session today. I hope you like it. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. एंड गाइज, आपको ये सेशन कैसा लगता है? खराब लगता है, अच्छा लगता है? प्लीज कमेंट करके जरूर बताएं. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.